Hi everyone, in this video I just would like to show you how simple and easy it is to connect your Overleaf account with your GitHub account, so you can keep always your code updated in GitHub, and you can either create first a Overleaf project and then push it to GitHub so you can share it with your colleagues or with the other people working in your team. Otherwise, you can do the opposite. You can create first a GitHub project and then import it in Overleaf. In this video, I'm going to show you both. I just have to mention, however, that in order to connect Overleaf with GitHub, you need a pro account. So in order to do that, you need to get a pro account. But if you're working for a university, check with your university, because sometimes you might get a pro account for free. Okay, so the first step that you have to do is first of all log in into your Overleaf and then click here in account and then account settings, and then you can just scroll down and then you just have to GitHub integration. So here there is going to be a button like this one here for Dropbox. I've already logged in, so you just have to click on this and you will just have to sign in into your GitHub account, and that's all. There is nothing else to do. So this is an example for Dropbox. Of course, you're going to just do the same thing, but for GitHub, okay? After you are done, it says your GitHub account is successfully linked, so you're ready to go. You can also link it to Mendeley and Zotero, okay? So as I previously mentioned, as I just said, just keep in mind that you need a pro account, so a paid account. Once you've done that, you can actually look at your projects here. I've already created one in a previous video, so if you want, just go and check out my video, how to get started in Overleaf. And this is the project that we have. So it's a very, very simple project, which I'm going to open right now, and it's just compiling. So let me just take off the review. Yes. So here we are, actually, this is not the project that I just want to show you. I just want to show you this one, YouTube Get Started. So it's just because it's a simpler project. Okay, so this is a very simple project in which we have a title, introduction, conclusion, references, and so forth. So if we want to now connect this to GitHub, what do? We click here on menu at the top. And then here on the left side, under Sync, there is GitHub, okay? Overleaf is quite smart, so it just tells us that this project is not linked with a GitHub repository. You can create a repository into GitHub, so we can click here, create a GitHub repository, and you can actually select your repository name and the description of the repository, okay? So for the moment, we'll just keep the same name for consistency. We can specify the owner, and we are going to keep it public. Okay, so it's going to be a public repository. So I click on create, and it should create automatically a repository in our GitHub. Okay, so this is very nice because now it's sync with GitHub. So if we go just in GitHub here, and we go and have a look at our GitHub, and now we look for YouTube Get Started. So this repository has just been created, and these are the same file that they were in Overleaf project, and as we specify, the repository is public, okay? So the nice thing is that you can also push Overleaf changes to GitHub. So every time you're going to make a change here, you can actually decide after a while. So let's actually going to change the introduction and let's add another section here. So we just copy this one down here and we can actually see the changes because at the moment we have track changes on. So you don't have to have track changes on or off. So we can actually just keep it off and keep the track changes off. So we're going to add a new section, which we're going to call it methodology. Here, and here we are going to write something like this is the methodology section. Okay, so as you can see, if you go here and you refresh this page, in the main text, nothing has changed. There is only the introduction. So our change is not being reflected in GitHub. The reason why is because we haven't pushed this change to GitHub yet. So in order to do that, we click here on menu, GitHub. Now we can see that there is no new commit in GitHub, but we can push these overleaf changes to GitHub. So we click this, we can type a commit message. So we added methodology, yes, and then we commit. Now it's merging into GitHub. Perfect. So now we should be able to go back here, refresh this page, and now we have the methodology section. In addition, of course, we have all the history, so we can keep track, and we added the methodology, okay? The same thing goes the opposite way. So if we are going to add a change, we are going to change the file here. So for instance, we go back here to the file, and you can do this cloning it on your computer. I'm just going to show you between GitHub and Overleaf. Of course, you can clone this repository on your computer and then make the changes. But let's actually edit this file here. So we click here on the edit, and now we are going to add another section, in which, in this case, we're going to call it and we're going to add the results. Okay, so after methodology, we're going to results. Okay, this is the results section. Okay, we of course have to commit the changes. So the changes, we are going to say added the results section. We're going to commit the changes. We are not going to create a new branch, commit changes. So now the file here has been updated, but of course here in Overleaf, nothing has changed because we haven't imported yet the changes from GitHub. So even if I compile or I refresh this page here, that's going to be the same because we haven't imported the changes. So we go back here, menu, GitHub, push, pull. So as you can see, before there wasn't anything, but now Overleaf knows that a new commit has been done by me and at a certain time, and this is the commit ID. So we can just do pull GitHub changes into Overleaf, and now the changes will be reflected in our file here. So if someone is working on your file, both from GitHub and Overleaf, you can always have these two files in sync, okay? The final thing that I want to show you is, of course, you can create first a project in Overleaf and then import it into, so first from Overleaf and then push it to GitHub. Alternatively, you can do the opposite. So for instance, if you want to do that, let's go back to the menu here. Actually, let's go back to the main page of Overleaf by clicking on this arrow here at the top. So here we are in my project. We can say new project, okay? A new project, we can have a blank project, example project, upload it from a file, or import it from GitHub. So we're going to import it from GitHub. Since we have connected it, we have all the repositories that we have on GitHub. And let's look for the one that actually I'm interested in importing it. So I just have to... Yes, so this is the repository that I want to import. So I want to import it to Overleaf. I click here. It's looking for the files inside the repository. Okay. And I will actually show you in a second that this repository is private. So you can import either public or private repository. And Overleaf is very smart because it's able to understand where the LaTeX files are and is able to import and create our file. So don't worry too much about the formatting of the file right now, because this is just an example. So let me actually go back here. So it's going to be looking a little bit better right now because it's not in two columns. Maybe I'm going to make another video of how to use the Elsevier article template. So this is my paper, blah, blah, blah. Don't worry too much about the data there inside. But what I wanted to show is that this was the repository in my So this was my repository, which I'm keeping for a research study. So inside here I have code, which contains all the code that I have. So this is the code that I'm going to use to analyze the data. And then inside here I have the manuscript, which contains all the files needed to generate the article and to generate the presentation. Okay, so as you can see, Overleaf was quite smart to understand where the LaTeX file were located. So we're actually inside the manuscript folder. He was able to detect all the files, and I've divided the files. So main is going to be the main file, which I'm going to import, and sections are the sections of the paper. So as you can see here in main, when we are in main here, we are importing all the different sections. So introduction, methodology, result, and Elsevier guide in this case. If you want to have a look at this repository, I have it public here on my GitHub. So if you look for my name and then reproducible research, I've actually created this repository, which you can clone it and you can read more about it. It's just to keep all your code organized and structured. And as you can see, it's super simple. As after you have cloned it on your computer, you can straight away import it in Overleaf, and it's just a one click of a button. The same goes to what I've showed you before. Now that these two repositories are linked, so now that this project is linked to GitHub, is when I'm going to make changes in this repository in GitHub, then I can import the changes here in Overleaf, and the changes will be reflected here in the file. Thank you very much for listening, and just like the video if you like the video and you find it interesting. Otherwise, leave a comment down below if you have any questions.